Namaskar. This is third part of our second chapter, solution. Let us start. Objectives. In this video, we will study colligative properties, relative lowering of vapor pressure of solvent, depression of freezing point of solvent, elevation of boiling point of solvent, osmotic pressure of solution, reverse osmosis, abnormal molar mass of solute, and want of factor. This part is most important. So, watch carefully. Colligative properties. Colligative is a Latin word. Here, co means together and ligae means to bind. So, what is colligative property? Those properties of a dilute solution. Here, dilute solution is very important because Raoult's law applicable on dilute solution only. Containing a non-volatile solute in known amount of solvent, which depends upon the number of solute particles, not upon their nature, are called colligative properties. Simply, we can say properties depend on number of solute particle only, not their nature. Okay, suppose we are dissolving 1 mole urea and 1 mole of sucrose. In water. Okay, change in vapor pressure will remain same in both condition. If you are dissolving 1 mole urea or 1 mole of sucrose. Okay, so this property is known as a colligative property. The colligative properties of dilute solutions are used to determine the molecular mass of that dissolved substance. The various colligative properties are relative lowering in vapor pressure, elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point, and osmotic pressure. First, relative lowering in vapor pressure. The addition of a non-volatile solute in volatile solvent decreases the escaping tendency of the solvent molecules from the surface of solvent. Its sum of surface area is occupied by non-volatile solute particles that we have already studied in the last part. When we dissolve non-volatile solute on surface, some surface area is occupied by non-volatile solute particles. So, escaping tendency of particles from a surface will decrease here, you can see. So, if escaping tendency of solvent molecules decrease, then vapor pressure will decrease. Raoult established that the lowering of vapor pressure depends only on the concentration of the solute particles and it is independent on their identity. Means this is a colligative property because it depends on their number only, not their nature. By Raoult's law, relation between vapor pressure and mole fraction, we have already studied PA equals to XA PA naught. What is PA here? This is a vapor pressure of solvent in solution, XA mole fraction of solvent, PA naught vapor pressure of solvent in pure state. The reduction in the vapor pressure of solvent, we can write del PA. What is del PA? Because here vapor pressure decreasing means vapor pressure of P pure solvent is more comparative to vapor pressure in solution. So PA naught, vapor pressure of pure solvent, minus PA, vapor pressure of solvent in solution phase. So this is a reduction in vapor pressure. PA naught minus PA naught XA. From here we can put value of PA. So it will come PA naught XA. Here, so PA naught common, so it will come 1 minus XA, and we have already studied in first part mole fraction XA plus XB equals to 1. Total mole fraction will be unity. So 1 minus XA, we can replace 1 minus XA with XB. So P del PA equals to PA naught XB. PA naught del PA naught is reduction in vapor pressure. PA naught, vapor pressure of pure solvent, XB. What is XB here? XB is mole fraction of a solute particles. For relative lowering in the vapor pressure, we divide this complete equation with vapor pressure of pure solvent. Then it will become divided with PA naught. So it will become del PA divided by PA naught. Del PA, we can write like this one, PA naught minus PA. So PA naught minus PA divided by PA naught equals to, here when we divide this one with PA naught, it will become XB. What is XB? Mole fraction. Mole fraction, we know, mole of substance divided by total mole of all substance. So PA naught minus PA divided by PA naught equals to NB, mole of B divided by NA plus NB, total moles, moles of solvent and mole of solute particles. For a dilute solution, we know in dilute solution the number of moles of solute will be less than compared to solvent. For a dilute solution, NB much less than NA. So neglecting NB in a denominator, so it will become NB divided by NA. PA naught minus PA divided by PA naught equals to NB. What is NB? Mole of solute. So mole, what is formula for mole? Mass in gram divided by molar mass. So we can put value for NB and NA. For NB, mass of solute divided by molar mass. So mass of solute divided by molar mass of solute divided by NA. So mass of solvent divided by molar mass of solvent. With the help of this formula, we can calculate the value of MB. What is MB? Molar mass of solute. So we can calculate molar mass of solute with the help of this formula. So this formula I use to determine molecular mass of solute particles in solution. Next, elevation in boiling point. Boiling point is the temperature at which the vapor pressure of a liquid becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. Simply, for water, if you want to boil water, when we heat water and its vapor pressure when become 1 atm, it will start boiling. So when a non-volatile solute is added to a volatile solvent, the vapor pressure of the solvent decreases. We have studied just now. In order to make this solution boil, its vapor pressure must be increased by rising the temperature above the boiling point of the pure solvent. Now we added some salt in this water. Salt molecules are non-volatile, so its vapor pressure decreases. To boil this solution, to make its vapor pressure 1 atm, now we need more temperature. Here in this graph you can see that when vapor pressure of solvent become 1 atm, it will start boiling. This is a boiling point for pure solvent. When we mix non-volatile solute, its vapor pressure decrease, you can see its vapor pressure decrease. This is a vapor pressure of solution. So to make it 1 atm, we have to increase its temperature. Now we increase its temperature TB not to TB. So what is TB here? Boiling point of a solution. So difference between TB not and TB, this is del TB. The difference in the boiling point of solution and pure solvent is called elevation in boiling point. Del TB equals to TB minus TB naught. What is TB here? TB is a boiling point of solution. TB naught is a boiling point of solvent in pure state. Experiments have shown that for a dilute solution, the elevation in boiling point is directly proportional to molar concentration of solute in a solution. So del TB directly proportional to molar concentration or molality. Del TB equals to KBM. KB is called boiling point elevation constant or molar elevation constant or ebullioscopic constant. The unit of KB is Kelvin kilogram mole inverse. As we know, molality, mole of solute divided by mass of solvent in kilogram. So we can put this value here. So del TB equals to KB NB divided by WA. Here if you are using gram, then we will divide by 1000. So NB here, mole of solute. This one, mass of solvent in gram. Del TB equals to KB WB into 1000 divided by MB into WA. Here NB, what is NB? NB mole of solute. So it will be gram mass of solute divided by molar mass of solute. So WB by MB. So with the help of this equation, we can calculate molar mass of solute in solution. MB equals to WB into KB divided by del TB into WA into 1000. What is MB? Molar mass of solute, WB mass of solute in gram, KB molar elevation constant, del TB difference in the boiling point, WA mass of solvent in gram, depression in freezing point. Freezing point is defined as the temperature at which the vapor pressure of a substance in its liquid phase is equal to its vapor phase in the solid phase. Simply, when vapor pressure of liquid become equals to its solid state, temperature known as a freezing point. A solution freeze when vapor pressure equals the vapor pressure of the pure solid solvent. When a non-volatile solute is added to the solvent, its vapor pressure in the solution decreases. Here you can see, this is for solvent, this is for solvent, this is vapor pressure of solvent, here you can see. But when we mix the solute, so in solution its vapor pressure decrease. So this is here del Tf, this is a freezing point for pure solvent. When we mix the solute, its freezing point decrease and temperature now become Tf. This is a freezing point of a solution. So difference between both del Tf minus Tf equals to difference between both Tf naught minus Tf del Tf. This is a depression in freezing point. The difference in the freezing point of pure solvent and that of solution is known as a depression in freezing point, del Tf equals to Tf naught minus Tf. Similarly, for dilute solution, depression in freezing point is directly proportional to the molality of the solution, del Tf proportional to M molality, del Tf equals to Kfm. Here Kf is a freezing point depression constant or molar depression constant or cryoscopic constant. Its unit is Kelvin, kilogram mole inverse, Kelvin kilogram mole inverse. And it depends on the nature of solvent. So del Tf equals to KFNB divided by WA into 1000. Same, NB mole of solute, WA mass of solvent in gram. Del Tf equals to KF WB MB into WA into 1000. Here NB mole, so mole equals to mass in gram divided by molar mass of solute. So with the help of this equation, we can calculate the molar mass of solute in a solution. So here MB molar mass of solute, Kf cryoscopic constant or molar depression constant, WB gram quantity of solute, del Tf depression in freezing point, and WA mass of solvent in gram. Next colligative property is osmosis, important property. The flow of solvent from pure solvent or from solution of lower concentration into solution of higher concentration through semi-permeable membrane is called osmosis. The flow of a solvent through SPM, semi-permeable membrane, from lower concentration of solution to higher concentration of solution. You can see this is our SPM, semi-permeable membrane, and this side sugar in water, here less concentration, here more concentration, these are sugar molecules. So water will flow from this side to this side through this semi-permeable membrane. So here you can see its level increase. So this phenomena known as a osmosis, flow of solvent through SPM from lower concentration of solution to higher concentration of solution. Semi-permeable membrane SPM, a membrane through which only solvent molecule can pass but not the solute ones. Okay, so here this is SPM. So this semi-permeable membrane is allowed to pass water molecules but not to sugar molecules. For some example of SPM, cellophane, parchment or cell membranes. Osmotic pressure will denote by pi. The flow of the solvent from its side to solution side across semi-permeable membrane can be stopped if some extra pressure is applied on the solution. So this is, we have a system here. This is SPM, egg albumin. Okay, here we are using concentrate solution and here pure water, okay, or pure solvent only. So because of osmosis, water will enter and its level will increase till H height. If we apply a pressure against this osmosis, okay, and that pressure just stop this osmosis process, then this pressure applied against this osmosis is known as a osmotic pressure. This pressure is that just stop the flow of solvent in is called osmotic pressure of solution. The osmotic pressure of a solution is the excess pressure to stop the flow of a solvent molecules through a semi-permeable membrane into the solution. Osmotic pressure is directly proportional to the molarity, here molarity C, of the solution at given temperature. There we used molality, here we will use molarity. So pi directly proportional to C. What is C here? C is molarity. Pi equals to CRT, C here molarity, R gas constant, T absolute temperature. So pi equals to NB RT divided by V in liter. So NB, what is formula for molarity? Molarity equals to mole of solute divided by volume of solution in a liter. So NB divided by V, NB divided by V, RT. Mole of solute, gram of solute divided by molar mass of solute, gram of solute divided by molar of solute, RT by V. So pi equals to WB RT divided by MBV. So from here we can calculate the molar mass of solute with the help of osmotic pressure. MB equals to WB RT pi V. MB molar mass of solute, WB mass of solute in gram, R universal gas constant, T absolute temperature, pi osmotic pressure, V volume in a liter, T absolute temperature. Absolute temperature means temperature in Kelvin. Applications. Osmotic pressure is used to determine molar mass of protein, polymers and other macromolecules, because here we are using macromolecule proteins. At higher temperature they are not stable, so this is useful because we can measure osmotic pressure as room temperature. So this is a important colligative property to determine molar mass of solute like protein, polymers, and macromolecules. On the basis of relative osmotic pressure, we divide solution in three parts. First, isotonic solution. If the solution having same osmotic pressure at a given temperature are called isotonic solution. Hypertonic solution. A solution having more osmotic pressure comparative to the other is known as a hypertonic solution. Hypotonic solution, just opposite. A solution having less osmotic pressure comparative to other solution is known as a hypotonic solution. Osmotic pressure of RBC equal to 0.9% WV of NaCl solution. If you will put RBC in 0.9% NaCl solution, then there is no change in shape of RBC because this is isotonic solution for RBC. But if we put RBC in solution containing more than 0.9% solution, more than 0.9% solution, then water will flow out from the cells and they will shrink. Here you can see. So this solution here known as a hypertonic solution for this RBC cell. In another hand, if we place RBC in a solution less than 0.9 concentration, then water will flow into RBC, so it will swell. Some another example for osmosis. Here you can see, here first example, a wilted flower revive when placed in fresh water. We use salt to preserve meat. The preservation of meat by salting. A raw mango placed in concentrated salt solution lose water by osmosis and shrivel into pickle. The prevent of fruits by adding sugar protects against bacterial action. Candied fruit. Some people are using more salt in their food, so they feel water retention in intercellular space or tissues because of osmosis. The resulting swelling is called edema. Plant absorb water by osmosis. Reverse osmosis, RO. If a pressure larger than osmotic pressure is applied to the solution side, the pure solvent flows out of the solution through the semi-permeable membrane. In this way, the direction of the osmosis is reverse, and so the process is called reverse osmosis. So what is reverse osmosis? If we applied a pressure more than osmotic pressure to solution site, then solvent molecule flows out of the solution. So this method we use, reverse osmosis, is used in desalination of sea water. In reverse osmosis system, when pressure more than osmotic pressure is applied, pure water is squeezed out of the sea water through the semi-permeable membrane. The pressure required for the reverse osmosis is quite high, so cellulose acetate film with a suitable spot is used as a semi-permeable membrane. So here, this is sea water. Here, SPM. When we apply pressure more than osmotic pressure, here water molecule pass through SPM and come this side. So here we will get pressed water. Next, abnormal molar masses. First, association. Association of molecules leads to decrease in the number of the particles in solution, results the decrease in the value of colligative properties. Here you can see when we dissolve acetic acid in benzene, so two molecules or acetic acid associate because of hydrogen bonding. Here you can see, and all colligative properties are depends on number of molecules of solute. Here number of moles of solutes decrease because two acetates join together and they form a dimer. So number of solute particles decrease, so colligative properties also decrease. Hence, colligative property is inversely related to the molecular mass, therefore higher value of obtained for the molecular mass than the normal values. So colligative properties depend on number of solute molecules. Number of solute molecules decrease, so colligative properties will also decrease. When we calculate molar mass of a solute particle with the help of colligative properties, we will find more than normal value. Dissociation leads to increase in the number of solute particles in the solution, result in the colligative properties. Since colligative property is inversely related to the molecular mass, therefore molecular mass of a substance is calculated from colligative property will be less than its normal value. So here when we dissolve NaCl in water, it will dissociate in Na plus and Cl minus. So number of solute molecules just become double. Here only one molecule, but now here Na plus and Cl just double. So if number of solute molecules increase or double, then colligative property also double or increase, and colligative property is inversely proportional to molar mass. So if we calculate its molar mass, it will come less comparative to its actual value. So if in solution association or dissociation is there, then calculated molar mass will be either less or higher comparative to normal molar mass. So this molar mass is known as a abnormal molar mass. Such a molar mass that is either lower or higher than expected or normal value is called abnormal molar mass. Want of factor I. It is defined as the ratio of normal molecular mass to the observed molecular mass of the solute, or abnormal molecular mass of the solute. Want of factor I equals to normal molar mass divided by abnormal molar mass, or observed colligative property divided by calculated colligative property, or total number of mole of particles after dissociation or association divided by total number of moles of particles before association or dissociation. For example, if you want to calculate I for NaCl, so I equals to total number of moles particles after association. After association, one is NaCl will give 2 mole, so 2, before 1, so it's I 2. Want of factor for NaCl nearby 2. Similarly for acetic acid, it become dimer, so after 1, before 2, so 0.5.
for acetic acid nearby 0.5, for NaCl nearby 2. Similarly, if you are using MgCl2, so it will dissociate in MgCl minus Cl minus. So I, after how many, 1, 2, 3 mole, before 1, so it's I value of Van't Hoff factor is 3 for this one. Van't Hoff factor express the extent of the association or dissociation of the solute particles in the solution. In case of the association in acetic acid, we just now we checked association 1 divided by 2, 0.5. So I will be I less than 1. In case of dissociation NaCl2, so I greater than 1. Neither association nor dissociation, I equals to 1. So for a solution, if I is greater than 1 means dissociation is there. If I is less than means association in a solute. I equals to 1 means neither association or nor dissociation. Inclusion of Van't Hoff factor modified the equation for colligative properties as follow. Relative lowering of vapor pressure of solvent PA naught minus PA divided by A naught equals to I Van't Hoff factor NB divided by NA. Just multiply with I. Elevation of boiling point del TB equals to I KBM. Just multiply with I Van't Hoff factor. Depression of freezing point del TF I KFM. Osmotic pressure of solution phi equals to ICRT. Thank you. This was our second chapter, solution. For more videos, subscribe our YouTube channel, or for career guidance, go to our blog spot.